Welcome back. This is the Clay Golem. This is Foundry VTT. This is Curse of Strahd. We are trying to finish off the Death House. Now we've got Monk's active tile triggers working. We can continue with this, which is good because my players are hot on my heels here and I need to get the Death House finished. So I'm going to do it anyway, so might as well record it for you guys just so that you can kick back, relax and watch me do stuff. Discovered a problem. Drawing tool. Go to draw text. I'm going to draw a text box here. I can edit this and I can change this word to anything I like. It doesn't change. It hasn't changed it, has it? Have I gone mad? I mean, you know, don't want particle effects. I don't need to worry about layers or anything like that. It doesn't change it. I can change the color of the lettering. It's just not doing it. There's nothing in here. I've got it as an object. I can change it to be information only. Nothing. It's nothing in lines or fill. It's just not changing text. So something a bit broken with that. Not sure why. It was working before. I guess it's a Foundry 12 little tiny glitch or something, because I mean the drawing tools are a core function. So excuse my terrible drawings that I've slapped on here just so that I can remember which area is which when I'm developing this. But first of all, first thing I need to do is put our walls in. So I'm just going to chill out and do those for a few moments. You're probably going to have a bit of music while I do so. Okay, right, so that's our walls in. Now what I do need to do is make sure that I've covered anything like, for example, I need to make an adjustment here. Come on, behave. Need to make an adjustment here. Want my snap on again. Oh, fiddly. Come on, zoom in. Thank you very much. How many of you were screaming at the screen right then? Okay, I need to put this in here. Oh, look, in fact, I need to put that all the way up there. Of course I do. Let's just move that there. Right, so there's a secret door here. So let's make sure we turn this into a door. Of course, I could have used the door tool over there, but I didn't. We want to make this a secret door. Easy peasy. It's going to be closed. Let's put a sandy stone noise. Lovely, that will do nicely. Now, any other doors on this map? I don't think there is actually. I'm not sure that there is. So that's all pretty cool and ready to go. So, I've got my scribbled numbers on here just so that I can reference the module properly and not get confused with my chambers. So, but 35, what's up here? So we're going to start by descending these stairs down here. Now I'm not using tile triggers and things to change levels because I want the party to stay together for this. Unlike the house where I'm happy for them to run all over the place, if they get isolated and killed, that's on them. But I want them to stay together for this bit. So the ghostly chanting noise we mentioned about, that's quite a few videos ago now, but when we were doing the first level of the dungeon, I need to find a sound effect to do that. Because it starts to get louder as they get towards this area here. So we want a sound emanating from here that is going to cover the whole area. It gets louder as they get closer to it. So what's actually in here? The characters can discern dozens or so voices in that. And each of these little alcoves here contain a relic of something that's really cheap and not worth anything. A small mummified yellow hand, a knife carved from human bone, dagger with a rat skull set in the pommel, all sorts of things like that. Now, I'm not going to create items for all of those, because if they do decide to pick them up, I'm just going to get them to note it down. They're not a big deal. We don't really need to worry about it. So that area is pretty much done. Yeah, really, really simple. It's all about kind of the role play. It's one of the things I do like about the Death House is it's not just battle. It's about the atmosphere and everything else. So this section over here, now this talks about this being a prison. So the cultists shackled prisoners to the back walls of alcoves here. So they don't have doors on. They literally have, I'm not sure if you can see. Can I bring the light up? I'm not sure how dark I had this. But they've got shackles on the image here. So then there's no cell doors on these. They're literally shackled to the walls. The prisoners are long gone. Their bones litter the floor. But rusty shackles remain. There's a secret door that we just saw here. That can be found with a successful check. Treasure hidden on the back wall of the cell marks X on the map is a human skeleton clad in a black robe. So this is this one here. The skeleton belongs to a cult member who questioned a cult's blind devotion to Strahd. Characters who search it can find a gold ring worth 25 gold. Have I got a gold ring? I bet I haven't. Oh, look, I have. Brilliant. I'm going to stick that in there as an item pile. I don't want my walls. I'm going to stick that in there as an item pile and just hide that. So if anybody finds it, I'm going to stick that outside the map, actually. If anybody finds that and does the search, I can just chuck that straight into their inventory. What I do want to check, this gold ring worth 25 gold. Yep, that map's going to match. Again, it doesn't matter if it doesn't match. You want to keep it reasonably balanced, of course. But I can give them whatever treasure I want. I don't have to follow the module, obviously. Well, maybe not obviously. I know new DMs often get stuck into, I have to follow the module exactly. And I know I'm creating the module as kind of closely as I can. But you really, really don't have to do that. Make it your own. You know, you've got to flex with your party what they want and what their actions are. Don't railroad them into your adventure, because it never ends well. Okay, Area 37, this talks about a portcullis. Portcullis. What's that? A portcullis. Tunnel is blocked by a rusty iron portcullis that can be forcibly lifted. So I need a wall in, don't I? So I've got it in. Brilliant. So this is going to be a portcullis. So movement restriction. Yes. Now, do I make this a door that is effectively locked? I might do that so that they have to do the roll. They can't just run through it. Block movement, yes, is a portcullis, so I'm going to say it doesn't block light, it doesn't block sight or sound. Metal? That's quiet, isn't it? Sliding metal? Yeah, it's still quite quiet on my machine, but I think that will do. Okay, let's make that portcullis. Characters can now see through it. Yeah, successful DC 20 athletics check to open. Otherwise, the portcullis can be raised or lowered by turning a wooden wheel half embedded in the east wall of Area 38. Well, inside. Okay, so they're suggesting that somebody needs to be in this chamber to be able to open, close it. Oh, there it is. Look. Okay, turn this, open the portcullis. But if you're on the outside, of course, you can't get in unless you know about the secret door. The wheel is beyond the reach of somebody east of the portcullis. The floor around the portcullis is submerged under 2 feet of murky water. Okay, so murky water is here and all around here as well. That's something, isn't it? Wouldn't it be nice if we can get a water texture effect, murky water, to place in here as a tile to show that that is all murky water? I'll have a play with that in a moment. But that's it. Portcullis is boring. It's just a portcullis. Which leaves us only, if I can select my other letter there, leaves us only with Area 38. Now, this is the big ritual chamber. This is where all of the cultists' rituals were performed, in the sunken room. The water is 2 feet deep. The ledges, the central dais, are 5 foot high. That's all fine. So we could use tiles and set levels and things. I'm really not going to. Half embedded in the east wall is a wooden wheel. Yeah, that's the mechanism for the portcullis. The hole in the west wall leads to a naturally formed alcove. Now, on this map, left is north. Okay, I don't know why they oriented it that way, just to make it really awkward. I guess when something's written for tabletop gaming, face-to-face, you know, paper and pen stuff, it doesn't really matter. But when you put it on here, everybody assumes top of the screen is north. It's going to drive me mad. Anyway, right, so what they're talking about here is a shambling mound. Let's find a shambling mound. It should be in the standard SRD, I would have thought. There we go, shambling mound. Let's stick that in there. Now, we are obviously going to hide it. You'll notice I've got my twizzly token on there, so it will move around, which is nice. But for now, I want to hide it so the players won't see it immediately. Okay, Logoth the Decayer is what they called it. It's asleep but awakens if attacked, or if characters summon the cultists but refuse to complete their ritual. So this is where it goes on about one must die, and the characters have to perform a ritual here. The character on the dais, when the cultists appear, must sacrifice a creature. So any character climbed on top of the dais read the following. The chanting rises once more as 13 dark apparitions appear on ledges overlooking the room. Each one resembles a black robed figure holding a torch, but the torch's fire is black and seems to draw light into it. Ooh, okay, so we've got anti-light. So one of the things in version 12 that we've not actually played with yet is they've updated the lighting so that you, instead of having light or absence of light, you can actually create anti-light, so actually areas of darkness. So that's partly to do with things like spells that create darkness and stuff. So that is kind of an area we might be able to use that. So I think what I want to do is I want to find a figure. You're like a token for a black robe figure. I want to attach a light to it that I'm going to make into like a black light, only slightly, so it's almost not noticeable. And then stick those 13 figures around here, around the, on these raised edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Obviously, they're going to double up a bit. That's not a problem. And then I might put an active tile trigger in the middle here. So as soon as one of the characters steps onto here, it will pause the game and reveal these figures and give me a chance to read the description there, which basically they chant, one must die, one must die, one must die. So it might be even that I find or make a kind of spooky chanting layered effect of somebody chanting one must die, and get it to automatically play that. So as soon as a character steps onto the dais, however you want to pronounce it, pauses the game, the figures appear with their torches, and that chanting instantly changes to one must die, one must die, and that will keep going until they solve it. So what it says is the characters on the dais, or the dais, when the cultists appear, must sacrifice a creature on the altar or face the cult's wrath. Creatures can ascertain what must be done on a successful intelligence, religion, or insight check. To count as a sacrifice, a creature must die on the altar. Apparitions don't care what kind of creature is sacrificed, and they aren't fooled by illusions. Well, a familiar is a creature, isn't it? Just saying. If the characters make a sacrifice, the cultists fade away. so we will need a button to make them fade out again. But their tireless chant of he is the ancient, he is the land, echoes again in the dungeon. Strahd is aware of the sacrifice. The Death House now does nothing to hinder the characters. But so the characters, the endings, depending what the characters do, is either they make the sacrifice, the house is appeased, everything calms, and they can just leave, and they can actually leave now. Or they refuse to do it. Now, if they refuse to do it, the Shambling Mound will attempt to attack them if it hasn't already, and then the Death House tries to attack them as they leave. All the windows are bricked up. The bricked up windows and outer walls are impervious to weapons and spell damage. All the doors are gone, replaced by slashing scythe blades. So our question, and I'd like your opinion in the comments, actually, of how we should do that, because this scene here is going to change potentially quite dramatically. I've got the darkness down. But all of these doors are going to be replaced by slashing scythe blades. So what do we do? Do we have some tiles with, you know, images of slashing scythe blades that we just drag in and pop onto all of these locations? I mean, that's not going to take too long to do that, is it, in mid-game? We could do that, you know, time for a wee break while the characters, you know, as soon as they go, we're not going to do it, let's run from the house, they can run through the lower dungeons, and then you can, you know, pause for a break, grab a drink, you know, in the next episode to be continued, kind of thing. Even if you're only taking a short break before they run, as the DM, you could come in and do that. So we could do that, and that's probably the quickest way to do setup. The other alternative is to create a completely different, or a copy of the Death House, and call it something like Death House Escape, which we might not ever use. But we can put in all of those things ahead of time. Now, it talks about every room that contains a fireplace or oven is filled with poisonous black smoke. So there's quite a lot of effects that we would want to put on the fleeing house. So what do you think we should do? Should we use the same map and just drag on those tiles and stuff when they escape? Or should we duplicate the entire scene and modify the scene for that escape room? One's going to take a lot more setup than the other. One of them is going to be much smoother to run the game. Let me know what you think, how we should deal with that. I'm leaning one way already, but I'd be really interested to know what you want to do. It talks about the interior of the walls, if they don't make a sacrifice, can be destroyed, but causes a swarm of rats to pour out and attack. So we're going to have plenty of swarms of rats on hand. I mean, obviously, you know, they're in the SRD, so it's not difficult. Let's just check if they're in. They should be. Whoops, I can't type. Swarm of rats, there we go. So that's nice and easy. We can just drag them out and go, yes, another swarm of rats whenever we need to. So there's no drama with doing that bit. So what do I need to do to finish this entire area then? I need to find the chanting sound that plays throughout the dungeon, which can just be general gothic-y kind of chanting. Don't need to be able to discern the words. I ideally want some chanting for one must die, one must die. Not sure how I'm going to achieve that. So I'll see what I can do about doing that. Find some ghostly figures to arrive, and then we can play with lighting. So I'm going to possibly take a break here and come back once I've done all that lot, and then we can continue finishing off this part. And then at the end of this video, I'll be looking for your suggestions on how we deal with the escape of the, you know, the house billowing smoke and blade doorways and all that sort of stuff. All right, I will see you back shortly. Okay, so we are back, and I have managed to find a couple of those sound files that I wanted. I've changed floor. I'm back on the first level of the dungeon, because this is where the chanting actually starts. So the chanting emanates from downstairs, so it draws them towards it. So I'm going to start off by putting sound in here, and obviously I want to find my new sound for this. I've already got them uploaded. I want to start with, he is ancient, he is the land. So I'm going to slap that in. Now, radius effect, I'm going to pop it up to 100. I definitely want volume easing on, so it'll get louder as we get closer. Now, if I just save that, I've got it constrained by walls at the moment, which means nobody's going to be able to hear it unless they are in this corridor. So I do want to take off constrained by walls. I don't need any of these special effects on here, I don't think. So there it is. Now, if I grab Haley, hopefully you can hear that. As you know, I do have some issues with the level of my sound effects compared to the rest of the video. I'm going to move Haley much closer. It should get louder. Right, turn that off so that's not irritating you guys too much. Hopefully that was kind of about the right volume-ish. When I... Excuse Haley, keep falling in the pit trap. Oh dear, keep sending it off. Yeah, hopefully that kind of is about the right sort of volume. So I've got that at the top of the stairs. So if I go to the second floor, we're going to have a different one here. Now, we've got a slight challenge here because what we're going to have is we're going to have the chanting that happens when somebody sets on the Diaz. Diaz, Diaz, whatever, however you want to pronounce it. Days, is it Days? Days is probably correct, whatever it is. When they step on here, we're going to change chanting. Before they step on there, we're going to have a different chanting. But I need the original chanting they can hear everywhere to stop when they stand on here, and it'd be replaced by this chanting. So how am I going to do that? How am I going to do that? So first of all, let's create a tile on here that we want. Now I'm going to give this an image. What I want to give this is just one of my interface images. Now the reason why I give it an image is because then I can change the opacity and make it pretty much invisible, which is, you know, it makes it disappear. Okay, so I've got this kind of grayed at the moment, but I will turn that right down when we're done. So what do I want this to be doing? Right, so for its triggers, I think I'm probably starting in the wrong place. I think what I want to do, let's leave that for a moment. I think I need to create another tile. Let's just put the black one out straight away. Okay, let's create this tile, just a small one here, and this is going to do pretty much one thing. So I'll leave it opaque for the moment. For its triggers, I don't want any triggers on here. Okay, it's not going to do, it's going to play our sound file for us. All right, so actions, I want it to play a sound file, and I'm going to pick our end comes, death be praised. That's going to be our chant. Turn that volume down. I want to play it for everyone, and I want it on a loop. Prevent sound if it's already playing. I will restrict it to the scene. That's fine. So in theory, when that tile is triggered, it will play that sound, but it's not got any triggers on it. So what I'm going to do, if I am smart enough, is it's a big fat if, isn't it? I'm going to put in a trigger up here that when anybody enters this trigger, in other words, when they come down the stairs, what I want it to do is just make sure that this sound tile, that sound tile, thank you, that sound tile is active. Okay, and sorry, a bit of clicking all over the place. And then I want to trigger that tile. Okay. Sorry about that little pop-up. So trigger that that tile. Select entity. Trigger that tile. Use this action's current collection. Not sure what that means. Use player tokens. I don't think that makes any problem. I just want it to trigger the tile. Use return data. Add this data. I don't need to return any data. Allow this tile to be triggered even if it's disabled. Yes, although I have just enabled it anyway. And I want to update this. What I do want to make sure is this is, once it triggers that tile, I then want this to deactivate itself. Deactivate this tile. Yeah. So, sorry, that wasn't very clear. What I want it to do is, what happened to my, was that the, what happened to my tile? Got that tile, I got that tile. What was the tile I was just editing? Oh, something's gone very weird. If this is the tile, this is the tile I want editing. Okay, what I want it to do is I want it to trigger, let's just make sure this is doing the right one, trigger that tile down there for player tokens, even if it's disabled, and then deactivate yourself. Okay, so it should only go off once. And it should make this tile here play that sound once it's triggered by that tile, right? That makes sense? Let's check that works. So, get Haley to move on to that trigger. And that appears to be working. Needed to stop. There it is. Is it going to stop? It's not going to stop. Oh no, that's going to delete all sounds. Oh. That's a bit weird, isn't it? Watch this. There we go. Genius. Okay, just quickly throw in a stop button for testing purposes. I won't need to stop that while we're actually doing. So, Haley walks on. Oh, it's not going to do it anymore because, of course, this tile deactivated itself. Yep, which is good. Haley walks on. The chanting starts, which is good. So we can hear that. And again, I will need to double check the volumes. All right. Click our tile, turn that off. Okay. Getting there, aren't we? So this tile, when they walk on this tile, what do I want it to do? Okay. So anyone enters this, we are going to, first of all, we are going to play sound file. No. We are going to stop sound on that tile for everyone. We are going to play your own sound file, which is going to be one must die. Okay, we're going to play that for everyone. We're going to, again, reduce that volume so it's not insane. We're going to loop it, absolutely. Prevent, restrict a scene is fine. That's all good. And now I've got these. So I put these figures out. You can see around here. And I've put them as tokens, but I'm wondering if I put them as a tile. I'm going to change that and put that as a tile. So let's stop those. Let's grab these dudes. And I'm going to put them out as a tile. Okay, so a one by one tile. And I'm going to pick my image for that. I think I put it under portraits, as you do. There they are. There's my monks. I can put that out and copy and paste. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And we'll put the other one there, 13. So we've got 13 of them, all right? Which is good. So we've got those out. So if I go back to my central triggering tile, what I do then want to do is to do show. Show hide. Can I do a group? I might not be able to. I want to show that. And can I put that in? Yeah. Oh, there's probably a quicker way to do this because this is going to take a few seconds to do, isn't it? Have a montage. Okay, so hopefully, let's hide all of these. Okay, hide. Now you might have seen in the middle of that, I had to adjust my button just to turn off my chanting. So let's take Hayley, let's drag her back up here, out of the way. So we've got no sounds playing at the moment. What we should have is when the player characters appear, they will set off this trigger here. I've got this deactivated, of course. There we go. So they can explore around here, listening to that chanting. Again, I hope that's not too outrageous for you. Let's just take Hayley through there. We come into here and we should trigger this. Got them both playing, haven't we? Let me trigger my button. Oops. Did it actually stop the sound playing on that one? That's working. Never quite as easy as you want it to be. Whoops-a-daisy. So you can tell my brain's working, can't you? So that gets set off.
The end comes, death, fear, grace, It's not stopping that one. Why is it not stopping that one playing? That button up there works. Stop sound on those tiles, yeah? This one has stop sound of that tile for everyone, yeah? Stop sound on that tile for everyone. What? Why is that not working? I might have to have a fiddle that offline. Yeah, I've got the right one, haven't I? It's not stop playing, it is stop sound. That tile for everyone. That should work. I might have to have a fiddle with that, just double check that's working. But anyway, you can see where I'm going with this. This video is getting ridiculously long. But with that problem aside, we can see that actually these figures did come into view as well, so we can run that. I'm going to extend this trigger button up on the top right here to be when they've made their sacrifice. I'm going to have one button, made the sacrifice. It's going to fade all those out again, and it's going to kill all the sounds and everything's going to go quiet. And then that way they can then leave the house. If they don't make the sacrifice, again, the figures will fade when they leave here, and all the chanting will stop, and of course they will think no problem whatsoever until they get back to the house and it basically attacks them. All right, so yeah, a bit of a weird one, sorry about that, a bit all over the place trying to figure out things as I go. Read the comments, guys, because there will be at least one person already commenting about an easier way to do what I've just done, whether it's around the sounds, whether it's around those tokens appearing, or rather the tiles of the monks appearing or not. Yeah, somebody will have a better idea. Please do always read the comments, because we've got brilliant people here who've got much more experience of some of these things than I have. Anyway, thank you for watching. Take care. I will see you in the next one.